Before crimping a terminal onto the end of a wire, you'll first need to cut it to length. And that's exactly what we're going to cover here in lesson number 2 of this wire terminals playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Cutting wire is super simple given that you have the right tools for the job, so I'm going to share my own personal choices here. Cutting small wire from 22 to 10 gauge. Now I'll consider small wire to be anything that's 10 gauge or smaller. And I have two different tools that I use for cutting this. I've got my 5-inch diagonal flush cutters and I've got my 9-inch diagonal cutters. Now the smaller ones have a spring inside of them that makes them a little faster to use. And I've heard the smaller ones are a little better for if you have smaller hands. The larger 9-inch diagonal cutters are simply larger versions and they have just, you know, a bit more leverage, but both of these will cut anything smaller than 10 gauge just fine. Now I will say that the larger 9-inch diagonal cutters are a bit more versatile of the two and are my go-to for cutting multi-conductor wire that we're going to talk about later. So if I could only choose one of the two, bigger is better in this case. Cutting large wire from 8 gauge to 4-aught. For wire larger than 10 gauge, I've pretty much only got one tool for the job, and those are the Klein 63030 1-inch coaxial cutters. Now for their size, it's actually pretty wild how good they cut big 4-aught wire. Now the Klein 63030 coaxial cutters will technically cut wire, you know, smaller than 10 gauge, but they're just kind of heavy and the jaws have to be like opened a little bit wider to be able to put the wires inside, which is why I have all three of these cutters in my tool bag. Cutting multi-conductor wire. Now you'll likely have multi-conductor wire somewhere in your electrical system, whether it's 10-2 Romex, 12-3 stranded, or even 6-3 SO cord. And for all of these, I don't really have any different tools. I'm pretty much just going to use the Klein 63030 coaxial cutters for all three of them, and it's going to cut through all three of them with very minimal effort. Now that said, the 9-inch diagonal cutters are going to work on flat 10-2 or 12-3, but with the Romex, since it's a little tougher, it may take two cuts to get all the way through it. Now to summarize all of this, here is a graph of what cutters I use for various sizes of wires. And understanding there's some overlap between them, I would say that the Klein 63030 coaxial cutters are a must-have. The 9-inch diagonal cutters are a nice to have, but sort of necessary as well. And the 5-inch flush cutters are good if you're working with lots of small wire or in tight quarters. Now we're going to be cutting wires throughout the rest of this academy, so be sure to bookmark this lesson for future reference and come back to it if you need a refresher, because going forward, I'm just going to assume that you now know how to cut wires. Now that you know how to cut wires, I'm going to teach you how to strip wires and cover what tools I like for that. Click up here to watch, and I'll see you over there. Crimping a, I spit all over the place, cut big 4-aught wire.
You look so proud of yourself right then.
I felt pretty proud of myself. For one, it's pretty easy, but for two, it almost hit the computer.